guys, welcome back to the FFP, and thanks for joining us here for our What's for Dinner Wednesday. Tonight we are going to be making the most epic fish tacos right after this. So first off, what we do for our fish tacos is we cut our fish into 1-inch strips. I did that earlier today when the kids were watching a movie. I'm going to take 2 limes. If you have a juicer, that would be ideal. I just do not have one. So I'm going to do it the old-fashioned squeeze way. I'm going to cut up my lime. Oh my gosh, I love that smell. It reminds me of my honeymoon and Corona. I'm gonna squeeze all of that lime on top of my fish. You wanna make sure your hands are obviously very clean because I also want to scrape all of this inside into the bowl because that part fries up when you're cooking the fish and it's so good. I'm gonna squeeze all these limes and then we'll move on to the next ingredient. I'm sure there's a better way to do this. If you guys know of one, comment below. What little doohickey do I need to get to juice my limes? Because this is getting old quick. All right, after I do all of my limes, I'm now finished. My hands are filthy, but I'm going to take my cilantro, cut off a bundle, and I'm gonna go wash this and rinse off my hands at the same time. Again, with the cilantro, if you've seen some of my previous videos, like what I like to do is bend it all over and then I just finely chop it. Miller's my sous chef tonight. If you guys saw yesterday's video, he was in the ER, but he is feeling so much better. He was roid raging so hard yesterday, but he is back to his normal, into everything, happy chipper self. So super thankful for that. I'm gonna add the cilantro with my fish and I'm gonna rinse everything off. All right, now we're going to add 2 tablespoons of garlic. I'm not going to measure it precisely because it doesn't really matter. I do like mine a bit more garlicky, so I'm gonna add a little bit more. I just buy the pre-minced garlic. Add 2 tablespoons of oil and I'm gonna toss it around. Oh, you're such a good helper. All right, now I'm gonna toss around my fish in this marinade. Ben is the one who fries up the fish in this house. I typically don't. So I'm just gonna get it all ready so it can start marinating for about an hour. I have made it just like this and thrown it straight onto the frying pan. I've also marinated it from like 8 a.m. to 7 p.m. So if you want more flavor, marinate it for a longer time. I usually don't go over 24 hours because I don't plan ahead that much and I've never done that before, but I'm sure it would be flavor packed. You just wanna make sure that you're being safe with your fish handling so you're not gonna get sick. Now that my fish is marinating, I'm gonna put the lid on and I'm going to put it in the fridge until Ben gets home and we'll start our next step of making the sauce and the guac for our fish tacos. All right, now we're gonna start with our guacamole. I am obsessed with guacamole. I just love it. Usually I use 4 to 5 avocados, but today I'm only using 3 because that's all I have. Usually what I do is cut my avocado in half. I make slices in it, get the pit out. I just stick my thumb behind the skin and then they can fall right out and I'm not wasting any of that avocado that can stick to the skin occasionally. So 1 avocado down. I was going to use more. I had 5 put aside for this meal, but I ended up eating 2 of them at breakfast. Sometimes I also, if it's like a, this is a pretty ripe one, I will just put my fingers beneath it and squeeze it out. To get the pit out of an avocado, I put the knife straight in it like that, and then just twist, and it will pop right out. And then I just bang it on the side of the trash can. This one's really ripe, like I said, so I'm just gonna squeeze it like this so that my fingers don't get really messy. My mouth is already watering. If you see behind me, there's a giant bag of chips. And that is what I'm going to eat with these avocados. A little bit on my tacos and a lot on my chips. All right, next, what I'm gonna do is some more lime. So I'm gonna take, I think I have one lime here that I'm gonna squeeze on it. Sometimes I do two, but this lime was very big, so I'm just gonna try with one. A lot of making guacamole for me is just taste testing as you go. This lime is a lot juicier than the one I used for the marinade. Those ones like had no juice in them. So now I took a little bushel of cilantro and I'm going to rinse it off. Throw away these stems. Get that water out of there. Again, I'm gonna crumple it up and I'm just going to finely chop it. Okay. Next, what I'm gonna do is a little bit different than what the recipe I am gonna post calls for. I just don't add onion to the kids' guac. So first I will mash this all up and then I will take like a little portion out for them with no guacamole or with no onion in it because they don't like onion and I don't wanna fight them on eating it. I like mine fairly chunky. I forgot to buy the tomatoes. So Ben is on his way home with tomatoes right now. Ben just walked in the door. I had called him and I had said, hey, can you grab some tomatoes on your way home? He said, sure. He just walked in the door and he didn't bring home any tomatoes. So we're gonna have guacamole with no tomatoes, but guys, you want to add tomatoes to this. It will be so much better with tomatoes, I promise, but I'm not gonna have Ben leave again to go tomatoes when he just walked in the door, because if you're a mom, you know that when your husband gets home, it's like, hallelujah. All right, so I just added another lime because it was tasting a little bland. I'm gonna add some sea salt. You can do rock salt. You can do plain table salt. You can do whatever you want. So you wanna make sure you don't mush it too much in the beginning, because when you add that lime and you add the salt, it breaks up the avocado more. So let's taste it. So good. I'll add a little bit more salt for Ben and I, but this is the kids, so I'm gonna separate that out for them. Now I'm gonna chop up an onion for Ben and I to put in ours.
Ooh, that looks good. Where's the tomato? Can I add extra tomato in mine?
Well, you know, I asked this guy I know to bring home some tomato.
Yeah.
And then he walked in the door and I said, oh good, I'm just waiting to put the tomato in the video. And then he was like,
no, he forgot.
I know, and I literally just called him twice about it.
Oh.
What a jerk.
What a dummy.
All right, I'm gonna cut up my onion. Usually I use about a quarter to a half onion, but that's when I'm doing a lot of avocados. And today I'm doing about half the avocados I normally do. So I'm gonna put my onion in there and I'm gonna mix it all around. And I'm gonna call that done. It would be much better with some, I don't know, tomato. I always try to make my guacamole about 30 minutes to an hour before we want to eat it, because the flavor becomes a lot more infused into the avocado and it's so much better. All right, fridge. Next, we're gonna be making our yum sauce. I have a brand new thing of Just Mayo I just bought. Get it? A brand new thing of Just Mayo. This is so good. It doesn't have any corn syrup. It doesn't have any gross soy or anything in it. It's just pure delicious mayo. I just added 2 tablespoons of mayo. Usually I would do sour cream as well, but since I am dairy free, we are not going to do that. But if you are not dairy free, 1000% do the sour cream. So I have about 4 tablespoons of mayo and I have a bunch of hot sauce. This hot sauce is from Trader Joe's. It is called jalapeno pepper hot sauce. It's really good. It's not too much like kicky in the face spice. It's just enough. So then I just mix it in. It is so much better if you can do equal parts sour cream. So I highly, highly recommend that. But since I am not, we just do mayo, and then the kids and Ben will just add a dollop of sour cream on the top of their taco. And that's done. And now Ben is gonna cook us up some fish.
All right, it is time to fry up the fish now. Becca already has everything cut up and marinating and ready to go. So the It's gonna be nice and juicy and smoky. 'Cause I'm the best. Whatchamacallit?
Your head is cut off, honey.
My head is a little cut off. I'm too tall.
He is good at decapitating himself.
Sure. All right, it's time to fry up the fish now. Becca has all the fish cut up and marinating. It looks disgusting. It looks amazing. It really does look amazing. I didn't mean that.
It smells good.
Maybe unconsciously it looks disgusting.
I mean, you wouldn't want to eat.
It kind of does look disgusting.
You wouldn't want...
I mean, look.
Can we not?
Okay. All right, so let's fry up the fish. It's gonna get really smoky, it's gonna be juicy. We wanna let these things burn a little bit on there to kinda get a nice crisp. We wanna, and make sure that you don't throw that crisp away, because that's like the best tasting part. Really? Let's get cooking. These will cook pretty quickly because they're already all cut up into kind of 1-inch strips or so. So I'm just gonna let them sit for a few minutes on one side and then turn them over, and they should be done in probably 5 minutes or so. So you want to cook these at a fairly high temperature, because as it's cooking, you want to start to get this nice little browning and kind of charred stuff going on, because that's the most tasty parts of the fish. And obviously with fish, you're wanting to cook it until it turns from a foggy color into just kind of a regular white color.
Crisp white.
Crisp and white. Oh, hi. Hi, thank you. So these are pretty much done. We're looking good. These are obviously going to get chunked up, so we can start cutting them in half to, you know, check the middle. Looking pretty good, nice and flaky. All right, and when you're taking these off, make sure you don't leave behind any of the burnt stuff on the pan, because that's like the best flavor. Make sure you scrape all that off, pile it on top. That'll be some nice extra flavory crunch on your tacos.
Okie dokie, artichoke. I want to put all this in my belly right now.
This stuff, you want to make sure and get all of that.
That is the best part. A whole new world. A new fantastic point of view.
Oh, that smells so good.
No one to tell us no. Or where to go. Or say we're only dreaming. A whole new world. Usual fashion, the kids are starting to melt down, so we're gonna get these tacos made. The kids don't like hot sauce on theirs, so I'm just gonna put them on Ben's and mine. So I add the sauce first, then next I do the fish, then I do guacamole on the top.
Hey Ben. Hey, guacamole.
Hey Ben.
Hey.
I wish this guacamole had tomatoes.
Oh man, that would be a perfect extra ingredient. Why don't you have any tomatoes, honey?
I don't know, like, I just totally forgot to get tomatoes. It's all my fault.
How can you do that?
Also got some cabbage that I'm going to sprinkle on top. And that's one delicious fish taco. Thanks, we've just done this 3 times. Thanks so much, guys, for joining us for What's for Dinner Wednesday. We're gonna eat,
we're very excited.
We're hangry, the kids are melting down. It's time to eat these delicious tacos. Don't forget to pair it with some chips. Maybe a side salad would be really good with it. I hope you enjoyed this. Comment below if you end up making it.
Don't forget the tomatoes.
All right, we'll try to do this conclusion one more time. The kids are melting down. Miller is hungry. Lawson is crying. It is time to eat. Thank you so much for joining us for What's for Dinner Wednesday today. Make sure you're subscribed to our channel to see our tomorrow's vlog, every day's vlog, and our next week What's for Dinner Wednesday. Make sure you hit that bell notification so you can see when we post, and we will see you guys tomorrow.